myself.
What's up?
What's up? I know.
Where you been at?
What? Yeah, and I don't know if you heard, but I go to my mom's. I go to.
I thought you had a cast on.
No, I have a boot. I can walk with it.
How'd you do that? Jumping off it?
I jumped on it. I jumped up. I was dancing and I jumped up and I landed.
I told you I
was jumping. No, I jumped up on my. It wasn't my ankle, it's my big toe. It's the bone that goes from my big toe. Yeah.
How are you watching the tablet playing video
games? I'm listening.
Talking on a
headset. I'm not really, actually. I just like to keep this on.
Right,
no, can you watch me for a minute?
I gotta go, but I'll shoot you.
Stop. Ow! Open fire!
I need more bullets! Toodaloo!
Thank you.
Guys, I don't know, but I might win this. I'm hoping. I don't know how I got that guy for 33 and then got him for 43, but the shield and then before I got him for health. This guy, so this is gonna be a flush factory ending. It's a weird ending. Now I know snipers are close. I wish I had a sniper. Everybody's over here. Someone comes up here, they're dead. Someone right there. Three people, but there's seven others. It's four people. It's five. Still four, actually, because I counted that guy before. There must be people over there. And there must be people in flush. There's nine other players, I mean, and I got all the high ground I need, so. And I'm not trying to give away my spot. I do hear sniping. I hope I'm in the circle at all. I mean, the biggest mount. I mean, this is a big mountain. I swear, man. I hate this game. Figure out how I'm gonna get down when I have to get down. Sounds like someone's close. Where's this? Blue team leader, right?
Location, this one could be found at Lonely Lodge inside the main mansion. So there's gonna be two different missions. Moving on to the next location, which could be found at Lonely Lodge, and it's like either the
Brian. my mom was like, what? So she picked me up and rushed me to the hospital, and it turns out that Lance had fractured my skull. He had hit me so hard that he actually cracked the side of my head. And I know I did not get any brain damage. I'm not... I think I forgot math, because I'm really, really bad at math. And then, when I was in the third grade, I went to Louisiana for spring break to visit my cousins. And they had this huge pool, and I loved to swim, so I swam all day. But that was a bad idea, because there were millions and millions of mosquitoes all around the pool. And I got bit like 1,500 times. And one specific mosquito was carrying this very, very deadly disease. And I was the unlucky one, and I got bit by this huge monster devil dragon mosquito. So I had all these bite marks all over me. And when I got back to Pensacola, my neck started to hurt really bad. Like, I could not move my head without a sharp pain shooting down my spine. And I said, Mom, Mom, my neck hurts really bad. My mom's like, you probably just slept on it wrong. And I was like, oh, that makes sense. And so I started throwing up everywhere. So my mom rushed me to the hospital, and the doctor said, you probably just have the flu or something. On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad do you feel? And I said, bleh. And I threw up all over his stupid 1 to 10 chart. So they started doing all these tests. And I said, oh, to a bigger hospital so they can try to cure me. So after about 2 weeks of being in the hospital, I was cured and everything was okay. And my mom bought me Super Smash Brothers for the GameCube. Getting a prize for not dying. I don't really know. But I love Super Smash Brothers for the GameCube. I played all the time with my brother and all my friends. And then after a while, I started getting really, really sick every time I was without feeling like I was gonna throw up. I stopped eating as much as I usually did, which was a lot. I could eat anything. I could eat a whole pizza. I could eat two double cheeseburgers. I loved to eat. So when I stopped eating, I lost a lot of weight. So I ended up seeing a doctor, and the doctor ran all these tests and didn't find anything wrong with me. So the doctor said, you must be faking it, or you just want attention. And my mom and Brian believed the doctor because he wasn't allowed to do anything until I ate all my food. I wasn't allowed to eat. I had to start thinking of ways of hiding food so it looked like I was actually eating. I would roll up the food in a napkin and put it in my pockets, or I would take really, really big bites of food and say I had to use the bathroom and not go into the bathroom and spit the food out in the toilet. This happened for years because no one would listen to me. No one believed me that I was sick. Now let's take a break from the medical problems and get into the YouTube part of my life. The medical problems will continue later. So I joined YouTube on December 8th, 2007, and I found out about YouTube while I was in the 7th grade. I remember I came home from school one day, and Lance was telling me about how his friend joined this cool new website called YouTube, and he was uploading videos and having so much fun. Recreate the Super Mario Got Milk commercial from like the 1990s, and I told Lance and his friend Patrick to film me with my little Mario toy, and then complete randomness happened. And I remember I clicked upload, and within an hour I had 2 views. I was like, oh my god, 2 views. I am famous. I am like Will Smith. People know me. I'm all around the world right now. But I probably got those 2 views from refreshing my own video page so many times. But I really thought it was cool and awesome how I could upload videos and people would actually see them. So I started making like 8 videos a day. I was making the most random, stupid videos ever. I ended up deleting most of my videos because I realized how dumb they were. So I decided to do videos of my little Mario wing plush doll, and I would review video games and do a bunch of random stuff. I got a couple of subscribers and a few views. But I thought I was doing pretty good. Then I found this guy named Froggy Company. He made plush videos, and he would make all these cool Mario freakout videos, and I thought it was the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. I loved his videos. I ended up messaging him, and we became really good friends, and he gave me tips on how to make better videos. And that's when I added Tony the Tiger and Shrek and Woody and all the characters you love today. And after I added all these new characters, my video views went up, and I hit 1,000 subscribers. I was like, 1,000 people? Like, that's so many people. And then I went and bought me a 12-set of Mario plushies for like $250, and I also bought a $150 flip video HD camera because I wanted my videos to be better quality. And I used all the money from my birthday and I just put it all towards YouTube because I really wanted my YouTube career just to blow up, and I continue to make videos and make more friends on YouTube. Now at the time, it was just me and my brother Lance doing these videos. glanced at the voice of Shrek, Mr. Pig, and Woody, and I did the voice of Mario, until I asked my friends Luke and Zeke to help out with my videos. Now, before me, Luke, and Zeke did these plush videos, we would always want crazy adventures for Mario plush. We really actually had a good time playing with these toys, and we were like, oh my god, what if we just film more funny adventures we go on, because if we're laughing at it, maybe other people will laugh at them too. So that's how the Mario Luigi Stupid and Dumb Adventure series was born. We built our stupid adventures that we usually have in our minds, and y'all ended up loving it, and the series exploded, and that's how Mario Luigi was born. Because y'all just loved it so much. So you can thank our stupid imaginations for that stupid character that y'all love so much. So now I have Lance, Luke, and Zeke helping me with my videos. Our video views exploded. We got thousands and thousands of subscribers. I got accepted into the YouTube Partner Program, which that was a very, very big deal. People loved us. I thought we were unstoppable. Until one day, Luke and Zeke told me that they were moving away to Colorado. And I was like, that's on the other side of the world, so now you can't help with videos anymore. So I said, hey, can we please do one more video to kill off Mama Luigi so people wouldn't wonder where he was? So that's what we did. We made that one last video where Mama Luigi died in an explosion, and then all of y'all unsubscribed and hated me, and I quit YouTube. Not really. Me and Lance continued to make videos even though Luke and Zeke were away, and you know, people were all like, where's Mama Luigi? Where's Mama Luigi? And I said, you know, that us being away. So don't you know, Zeke voiced Mama Luigi. Luke played some of the characters too, and Luke and Zeke both moved away. So that is why Mama Luigi is not in my videos anymore. So stop yelling at me about it. So after Luke and Zeke left, I needed to find a new voice actor for my videos. I didn't want to have to make Lance do all the voices of all the characters. Then I met Lavelle. Now, Lavelle was this crazy kid in my reading class, and I thought he'd be the perfect fit for my videos. I went up and said, hey, you want to help me with my YouTube videos? He said, sure, you can kind of form some of my rap songs that you're on. I said, Chef Pee-Pee, and my videos blew up again, and people still cried about Mama Luigi, which made me really mad. So my YouTube was back on track, and I was doing really good, but my health was doing really bad. See, I started feeling worse, I started losing more weight, and my doctor decided to put me on a feeding tube, because he thought that would make me gain weight super fast. But he was super wrong. The feeding tube sucked. It hung off my stomach like I had a stupid squid tentacle. I looked like Koopa Koopa from Super Mario Sunshine. I had to be fed this milky jelly stuff that got all hard. It would clog up the tube and we would have to flush it. The feedings would make me feel horribly, horribly sick, and I would have these weird seizure things from the pain being so painful. While all this was happening, I was a junior in high school. I had to go to school with a feeding tube, and it would poke out of my shirt, and it would make me look like I had a stupid boner in class. And my school life had its ups and downs. I was the quiet kid. I didn't really talk that much, and I kind of got bullied when I got into high school, so I know I was that kind of mature. But, you know, I really wasn't the kid that, like, everyone knew, and I only had my, like, little set of friends, and I kind of stayed away from the big crowd, and the feeding tube didn't really help with making friends. It kind of made me look like I was some weird kid, and this feeding tube sucked really bad. It made me so sick, I had to miss a month of school. I was actually thinking about killing myself because I was so sick. I didn't think there was a reason to live anymore because all I felt was pain and suffering. Even though I had a girlfriend, a family, and thousands of fans that loved and cared about me, I just didn't see a reason to move on in life. My mom noticed how much I hated life, so she said that I should be a more professional doctor. So I took a week off school and I went to Tulane Hospital in New Orleans. I was going to go see this professional god of a doctor named Dr. Hyman, and he was supposed to be the best doctor in the country, and he would fix my stomach problems once and for all. But that's not what happened. He was a horrible doctor. The only good thing he did was remove my feeding tube, but other than that, he kept me drugged up for a week, and he ran tests on me that did not make any sense, and he made up a bunch of lies about how if I didn't stay in the hospital for 6 months under his care, then I would die. This guy was saying, so we packed up our stuff and went back to Pensacola, and now we're back to where we started. I'm still really sick, and now I have a scar from my feeding tube. So now it looks like after a while, my mom took me to see another doctor, and this doctor's name was Dr. Miller. She was amazing. After the first appointment, she figured everything out. She found out that I had superior mesenteric artery syndrome. It's a very deadly intestinal disease, and it's very, very rare. I was upset and scared because I didn't. didn't know what was going on. I eventually had to tell my principal at school about my sickness. I was missing so much school, I thought they were going to kick me out. But my principal understood everything, and he let my teacher, Miss Reeves, sell purple and around the entire school. A lot of people were wearing them. I saw people wearing them every day. Now that I know what is the case, well, my doctor told me that she could perform a surgery to pop.
Still have a party, still have a party.
God. I got baptized on November 4th, 2013. It felt great to go to church all the time, but I slowly stopped going and I found myself messing up again. I stopped focusing on YouTube. I even got my first speeding ticket, and it was a bad speeding ticket. I was going 66 miles per hour in a 30 mile per hour zone, and that's 30 miles per hour over the speed limit. So in Florida, you get arrested for going that fast. But I almost got arrested that night. The cop decided to...
The what?
Way to make a living, and I just want to thank all of y'all again.
No, I don't. I don't. Okay. Okay. What? No. Wait, what did you say?
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god, just shit, Junior!
Joseph?
Excuse you, it's Joe Lightyear.
What, yeah. Joe Lightyear?
Yeah.
Joe Lightyear now.
Well, why is he wearing that suit?
Oh, I'm a superhero, dude. I'm a superhero robot that saves the day.
He's a Pluto from Space AIDS.
Yeah.
Space AIDS?
Yeah, it's like AIDS that affects an entire planet.
Why is it like that suit on?
Well, you see, he got decapitated flying his convertible space shuttle, and then a space hobo cut his head off, yeah.
Those damn hobos.
What can that suit do?
I can shoot lasers and everything.
Oh, shoot a laser!
The bed's broken over.
Yeah, and last time he shot a laser, he accidentally destroyed Neptune.
Yeah,
you shouldn't
do that. I can't destroy a planet. Yeah.
Well, it doesn't feel like it's 50 years in the future.
What? You don't believe it's 50 years in the future? What? Come look at this futuristic newspaper, Junior.
Yeah, look at that.
February 26, 2067.
Yeah, that's today.
But Mars News, why'd you say Mars News?
Oh, because we live on Mars now.
We live on Mars?
Yeah, after World War III, Earth just got totally destroyed, so we had to move to Mars.
Yeah, Trump went to war and everything.
Can I go outside and see Mars?
No, absolutely not. There's no air.
You can't breathe out there.
Yeah, you can't go outside ever.
Zombie Hitler makes peace with aliens?
Oh, yeah, he's a president now.
He's the president.
Oh, but he killed a lot of people, though.
Zombie Hitler, he's great. He's much nicer than alive Hitler.
Yeah, dude, he throws parties like every Friday.
He's really sorry for what he did the first time.
This future's really cool, and it's really shiny, too.
Oh, you haven't seen anything yet.
What are you talking about?
Come look.
Okay.
Come on, dude.
Take a look, Junior.
What?
This is your living room. It's all shiny because it's the future.
What? Everything like this?
Everything looks like this. Even your kitchen.
What? My kitchen?
Yeah, come take a look.
Whoa! This is the kitchen?
Yeah, look. There's Chef Beep Beep. Or should I say Chef Beep Beep?
Oh, he my damn light.
Well, Chef Beep Beep?
Yeah, he's a robot chef now. He can make whatever you want.
Whoa, really?
I'm Chef Beep Beep. Look, Cody, why the hell do I have to be a chef again? Why can't I be a president or something?
You silly Chef Beep Beep. You know Hitler's the president now.
Yeah. Hitler's the president. Ooh.
Chef Beep Beep, I'm really hungry.
Give
me the cereal. Give me the cereal.
Are you hungry, Junior?
Yeah.
Well, I'll bring food over to the table for you. Just sit at the table, okay?
Come on, Junior.
Okay. So everything is really this shiny?
Well, yeah, Junior. What did you expect from the future?
I don't know. It just seems like it'll get annoying with what type of cereal do they have in the future?
An aluminum toast crunch.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Here's your cereal, Junior.
Oh, okay.
Chef Beep Beep, where is your hat?
Too?
Oh, yeah, everything's shiny, Junior. But you'll love it, I promise. You can eat it. Just go ahead and have some.
Bon appetit.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Just get a spoonful. It's really good, I promise.
Okay.
Very nutritious.
You!
I want to see Blaine!
That's bad, dude.
I didn't do that.
Yeah.
But
the next video.
Yeah, but everything else is covered. It's just covered on the next
fly around infinitely without deploying my glider or anything. And like the craziest thing
celebration.
Oh my god!
Good job. Oh, I got you with that!
Oh my
I
god!
I got you with the elimination. What the?
Oh yeah, no shooting things down, by the way. Yeah.
Oh damn, you guys are going quite high. Oh my days. You're good builders.
Dang it, no!
Ready?
Bye, guys.